A note on quartet. Oh, James Ivory's quartet. Not Dustin Hoffman. Or other quartets. I've seen Dustin Hoffman has one. Very interesting, even if it's not one of the masterpieces or most acclaimed works of James Ivory. A wonderful man, genius. Even his name is lovely. Ivory, James Ivory. The film is worthwhile, worth watching. I agree with other critics in not putting this at the top. I mean, this is not the best he offered the audiences, James Ivory, but it's notable, and I think it's a very good movie. The cast is led by three wonderful actors, one actor and two actresses, actually. Isabella Gianni, extremely beautiful. This was a period in which she was shining. I've seen her in Le Jour de la Jupe, the day of the skirt or something, where even if still good, she lost some of her splendor and magnetism. I thought, but here is, she's just, speaking of why watch the movie, she's just a pleasure to watch. She acts well, and she's so delicate and beautiful and resplendent, really. Wait, she's married to an art dealer who gets to buy Termina in the first scenes, the Sword of Napoleon. And he's selling it, sending it to America. And that's illegal. And indeed, he gets arrested and even sentenced to 1 year. And part of the movie, during part of the movie, Isabella Gianni, Maddo, as her nickname is, has to go and see this man in jail. But once he's arrested, she's left not just without his moral, psychological support, but she has no means. Enter the stage, Alan Bates, aka HJ, that's what they call him, and his wife, Louis, Maggie Smith, two fabulous actors, of course. Maggie Smith is acting even now at the age of, I don't know, 89, I don't know how old she is, and doing so, you know, fantastic manner. I'm thinking Downton Abbey, nominated. She was nominated, and I think she won at least one award of that for that. I mean, in terms of Emmy or Golden Globe, major. I'm sure they gave her many other awards in various circumstances, festivities, for that only. Lady in the Van, again nominated, and winner of awards. She is a painter in this film. And we're getting into a love triangle, because HJ says, when he finds out about this woman they know, Maddo, we should help her. What do you mean? Well, we should give her a spare room. I mean, you're bored, and that's why. And why not? Well, we don't know anything about her. And we only know she's the wife of a convict, of a prison, a jailbird. It's not exactly in these words, but it's part of the dialogue, the idea of it. And indeed, the Maddo comes to stay with them. HJ was not just a generous man trying to help her out. He's pushing and he becomes her lover. And tension rises. There's some very heated exchanges. In one moment, for instance, HA is discussing with his wife, and as she is around, Mado hears some of the dialogue and comes in, and she's, what do you mean? What are you using me for? And I want to leave. And it gets ever more complicated because the husband finally is out, and he talks with what could be in other circumstances the other injured party, I mean with Louis, and she says, you know, your wife, she's high strung, and then HJ, I wish you wouldn't get too far with that. What do you mean? Well, you know what I mean. I don't know, I've been away. Well, I think you should take your wife away. Well, I when I travel, says this husband, the convicted dealer of art in illegal, the one who deals in art in illegal ways. When I travel, I travel light. I don't carry baggage with me, something like that. So that is poor Mado, beautiful Isabella, Jenny. It's just the baggage. Well, talk of chauvinist male pig.